Bill Clinton is involved in two major uranium scandals involving the Clinton Foundation, not just one. It is already well known that former President Bill Clinton was right in the middle of the now widely reported criminal Uranium One deal. What isn't well known is that this was the second of two criminal uranium deals involving the former president and the Clinton Foundation. It has been widely reported that Bill Clinton flew to Russia in 2010 and was paid $500,000 for a single speech. It is also well known that during his trip to Russia, the former president petitioned the State Department to allow him to meet with a key member of the Russia state-owned uranium company Rosatom. The Hill reported in October. As he prepared to collect a $500,000 payday in Moscow in 2010, Bill Clinton sought clearance from the State Department to meet with a key board director of the Russian nuclear energy firm Rosatom, which at the time needed the Obama administration's approval for a controversial uranium deal, government records show. Arkady Dvorakovich, a top aide to then-Russian President Dmitry Medvedev and one of the highest-ranking government officials to serve on Rosatom's board of supervisors, was listed on a May 14, 2010, email as one of 15 Russians the former president wanted to meet during a late June 2010 trip, the documents show. The Hill continued in noting that Bill Clinton instead got together with Vladimir Putin at the Russian leader's private homestead. Bada bing bada boom. A short time later, the Obama's administration approved the sale of 20% of U.S. uranium to Russia. The Clinton Foundation walked away with millions and the U.S. lost one-fifth of its uranium to rival Russia. We also now know that former head of the FBI Mueller hand-delivered uranium to the Russians on a special trip where Hillary Clinton specifically asked that Mueller be the one to deliver the uranium. We also now know that the FBI uncovered Russian bribery of the Clintons in 2009 and the Department of Justice and the FBI sat on this for four more years. Worse yet, from a recent report we discovered the investigation was supervised by then-U.S. Attorney Rod Rosenstein, who is now President Trump's Deputy Attorney General, and then-Assistant FBI Director Andrew McCabe, who is now the Deputy FBI Director under Trump. Mueller is now heading a corrupt investigation into Trump on Russia collusion after being appointed by Rosenstein. This madness was orchestrated under Attorney General Jeff Sessions, who recused himself from Russia-related investigations. Greg Jarrett from Fox News and many others are calling for Mueller to step down. What isn't widely reported is that the Uranium One deal was the second crooked deal involving many of the same actors, uranium and the Clinton Foundation. The New York Times reported in 2008 that Bill Clinton was involved in another uranium deal that led to millions for the Clintons. Late on September 6, 2005, a private plane carrying the Canadian mining financier Frank Gistra touched down in Almaty, a ruggedly picturesque city in southeast Kazakhstan. Several hundred miles to the west, a fortune awaited, highly coveted deposits of uranium that could fuel nuclear reactors around the world. And Mr. Gistra was in hot pursuit of an exclusive deal to tap them. Unlike more established competitors, Mr. Gistra was a newcomer to uranium mining in Kazakhstan, a former Soviet republic. But what his fledgling company lacked in experience, it made up for in connections. Accompanying Mr. Gistra on his luxuriously appointed MD-87 jet that day was a former president of the United States, Bill Clinton. Upon landing on the first stop of a three-country philanthropic tour, the two men were whisked off to share a sumptuous midnight banquet with Kazakhstan's president, Nursultan Nazarbayev, whose 19-year stranglehold on the country has all but quashed political dissent. Mr. Nazarbayev walked away from the table with a propaganda coup, after Mr. Clinton expressed enthusiastic support for the Kazakh leader's bid to head an international organization that monitors elections and supports democracy. Mr. Clinton's public declaration undercut both American foreign policy and sharp criticism of Kazakhstan's poor human rights record by, among others, Mr. Clinton's wife, Senator Hillary Rodham Clinton of New York. Within 2 days, corporate records show that Mr. Gistra also came up a winner when his company signed preliminary agreements giving it the right to buy into three uranium projects controlled by Kazakhstan's state-owned uranium agency, Kazatomprom. The Times continued. Just months after the Kazakh Pact was finalized, Mr. Clinton's charitable foundation received its own windfall, a $31.3 million donation from Mr. Justra that had remained a secret until he acknowledged it last month. In 2008, the gift, combined with Mr. Justra's more recent and public pledge to give the William J. Clinton Foundation an additional $100 million, secured Mr. Justra a place in Mr. Clinton's inner circle, an exclusive club of wealthy entrepreneurs in which friendship with the former president has its privileges. The Clintons made millions, Russia took one-fifth of U.S. uranium, and together they now are working with their crooked partners in the FBI and deep state to pin false Russia collusion charges on current President Donald Trump. You can't make this stuff up.